guys, welcome to another episode of Mind Sugar Magic. We're here at the vegan foods market today, and we're gonna try out some food. Charles?
I'm really excited. The vegan foods market is one of my favorites, and it's one of my suggestions. The first time we actually went to vegan market, I went with Kirk. We weren't dating, but it was a date. And it's a special place in my heart because we love good food. And yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna take you on the journey. Let's go. The location we're at today is at the Range in Kukai. We had a special invitation by Sean, also known as Sean the Vegan. You can check him out on Instagram. We are done ordering all our food and it's time to munch.
Yes, the best part.
Charles, what did you get to eat?
So, first and foremostly, what is a sundae without the kusista?
Yes.
And I've had these already from bowing out. And guys,
bad boys.
This is the Cape Malay kusista that I know and love.
And we make it fresh.
Fresh, fresh.
Quick, fast.
Yes.
Okay,
you
let's,
ready?
Let's testify this.
Okay, I want that. Oh, it's nice and warm, guys. Look at that coconut tea. Goodness. So la, yummy.
Yes. Oh, yes. Perfection inside. Guys, you should try. You should just try it.
Please
do. You can't enjoy this alone.
Thank you.
Let's go, slaughterhouse.
Listen.
I'm listening.
I'm sitting in my mom's lounge right now.
Bro, organize me a cup of tea. I like the fact that it's fresh, that they just made it.
I don't want to eat the whole thing because I don't want to ruin my appetite.
You know me, I'm a big eater.
So,
what did you get to drink?
I got this kombucha. It's from my favorite brand. It's Wild Leaf, and she actually stays in Berkeley. And she makes it herself. She brews it. This is a new flavor they're trying out. It's carrot, lemon, and ginger, I think. And it's so lekker. The ginger is like doing all the things for my sinus right now.
I'm always skeptical.
What are you getting?
I'm skeptical about shaking this.
It's Don't not, shake it. Just
Toss it around.
Toss it, yeah.
So I got a juice from Delicatessa by
lemonade.
No, this is not the lemonade, this is the passion fruit. And it has little pips at the bottom, so it's like super fresh and pieces. Testify.
I know you don't enjoy this. Is like a very apple cidery. So I don't know if you'll enjoy it, but I'm enjoying it. They don't really taste the carrot, but the ginger is very strong.
This tastes very fresh.
And
not,
it does.
And it's not too sweet also. It's just like refreshing, like a palate cleanser.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice. It is fresh. You can taste it's fresh. It's not artificial. It's actual Grenadella. Okay.
So with the kusistas, we got some spring rolls. And
What's in the spring roll?
Are you gonna introduce this magic? Where did we get this?
This is also from Bowing Out.
Also Bowing Out.
This is hot. The food is hot, eh?
Yeah, it's fresh. They do everything fresh.
Okay, so inside there's a little mixture of veggies. And it's got the sweet and sour sauce over it.
Okay.
So I don't know if you want to grab that one.
Okay, we want to go halfies.
Yeah, I think we need to halfies. It's very hot.
Oh, it's like a coleslaw, cabbage, veggie. That's a treat.
It's a very naughty starter.
That's a treat. All the goodness. Sweet.
I'll eat all three of the sap.
It's light, yeah.
Without the issue. Yeah. Mm. Even though it's deep fried, it's nice and light.
Nice and light. Up. And we're gonna go on to the mains. I got from Vegan Street Food. Actually got the menu over here. They have like a little cool menu and things. They sell a lot of fast foods. And I got the Beyond Burger patty.
It's a beef, no?
It's beef, yeah, with cheese, vegan cheese, lettuce, and a nice big bun with some...
Ooh, that looks yummy.
Some creamy mayo sauce and wedges.
So, fun fact, tell them the fun fact about this burger.
Fun fact about this burger is, it was on our first date that we enjoyed this burger.
Yes.
I hope that is the fun fact.
That is the fun fact. So, let me tell it in my cinematic way.
Okay.
So, we were talking, we actually went, our first date was the first Thursdays. Official, unofficial date. And then we went to a cafe in town and it was disappointing, like the food wasn't that great. And then Kirk told me about this Beyond Burger and he's like, that's the best burger you'll ever taste. And then he invited me to the market the next day for the second date. And then the Saturday. And then we did it and I was like, yo, tastes legit like Burger King. It's actually one of the best burgers I've ever had. I'm not gonna lie.
Super, super fresh, like the I don't taste processed the Beyond.
Yes, it tastes. It's lovely. It's really lovely. Go for it. You can go all in. I was thinking, I feel like having home cooked food today. I'm tired of burgers and stuff, and I'm very much a curry person. So I decided to go with the bunny chow from. Marvelous Munchies.
Marvelous Munchies. We'll drop all the handles of all the food shops.
Yeah, so in this, there is coleslaw. And then it's a bean and imitation mutton curry.
On a lekker
bread. I don't know, we lost it at a bunny chow, bro.
I just want to say, the first time you pick up this burger and you feel this roll, it's like grabbing a cloud. It's like super fresh and soft.
Oh, did you?
Get in there, get in there. Oh, yes. Go. Mm.
Listen, this is a freshly baked bread now.
It even looks legit like meat.
This is an Indian turban curry.
I got the spices on point.
On point, bro.
How's the mutton pieces?
I didn't get a piece yet. Okay, there's a mutton piece. Why? Is this real mutton?
No.
It wouldn't be, right?
It can't be. The whole menu is vegan. It even looks fatty and it looks
meaty. Looks like legit. Guys.
Let me taste.
No, it is. It's an alternative. I don't know if it's a real thing. It can't be. It's at the vegan market.
It can't be, yeah.
It's so good. It looks like the real thing.
It has that fatty texture, so that mutton has that meaty fatty texture. Oh, babe, that spices is on a level.
Let me taste your burger.
Get in there. And what's your first thoughts?
That's Burger King. That's vegan Burger King. I'm telling you straight up. That is... Yo!
If you don't come to the vegan goods market...
I'm gonna have to buy one
and try a burger. A Beyond Burger.
You're missing out.
You're missing out big time.
And then also, fun fact, Kirk probably doesn't know this. Today, I don't know, we're talking a lot about our relationship. I think it's very nostalgic for us to come to the vegan market. But when Kirk and I first started dating, no, we would also go out and eat and whatever. And I'm very much a sharer with food and stuff. And I know a lot of people that don't like sharing their food. And I was so skeptical, like, sure, but am I going to be with someone that doesn't like to share their food? And I'm so happy that he does. Like, he's always asking me to taste of his food, and I'm always like, just taste.
But yes. Just a little bit.
Just a little just bit, a yeah. Little no, bit. We're not gonna go overboard, but he always allows me to taste of his food.
Yeah, why not?
Like, I was very afraid. Like, I was like, oh my gosh, what am I getting myself into?
Isn't that what the saying is? Sharing is caring.
So, I'm giving this a full-on 10 out of 10. It's not as spicy as I would have liked it, but I mean, I'm not in the mood for like super spicy.
I give the burger 10 out of 10. The burger never disappoints. I'm going to say that for a fact. The wedges though, because it's air fried wedges.
It is a bit alive.
It's a bit alive, yeah. But it works. It works. Burger and chips, try it out, guys.
Okay.
So for dessert, I grabbed me a chocolate brownie from the deli, the vegan deli. And Charles wasn't feeling for the chocolate brownie.
No, I'm not in the mood for sweet today. I don't have a sweet tooth. I don't have, but that's also another interesting thing about, I'm not a sweet tooth person. Kirk loves anything chocolatey. That brownie looks amazing though. That's how I like my brownie.
Oh, yes, let's go.
I like a cakey brownie with some moisture inside. Yes. That's my...
Guys, don't fear when you see this brownie. go in with confidence. I don't know if I'm speaking to the people or to myself.
I think you're hyping yourself up there.
Let's go.
Oh, that sounds lovely. Verdict? And it looks very chewy. Oh, there's chocolate on top as well, like a layer. I'm enjoying my kombucha.
Guys, there's so much chocolate, I'm even scared to talk.
Because your teeth.
But that was perfect. Nice and moist in the middle. And has an outer crispy chocolate brownie
yes,
vibe.
That bake, that yes, that bake on top. It looks very lekker.
Oh yes, let me get in here. Look at that. Oh yes.
You're making me less, and I know I'm not going to enjoy that sweetness, but you're actually making me less.
Just have a small piece.
I'm good.
Are you sure?
100%.
I'll keep a sticky for later.
Yes. But not right now. So, if you guys like the munch thus far, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. Let us know let us know what are your favorite markets in and around the Cape, and we will make a mission. I love a good market. The next one I want to try out is there's an organic market in Skaapkraal that I really want to eat. And yeah, this is always an amazing experience. This is a new venue. Sean, we just want to say well done in choosing this new venue.
It's beautiful, it's amazing, the people, yes, the vibes.
And also, it's like liquor close to home on the south. Also, you can also mission out if you want to. If you're from the north, it's beautiful. You get to see Table Mountain. You get to see the vineyards. It's stunning. It really is beautiful.
Dog friendly.
Yes, dog friendly.
You can bring your kids. There's a play area at the back also.
Really such a vibe. There's live music. Also, the live music is more engaging because it's in the middle of the market. So, yeah, even local artists, if you are keen to perform, and come and show your talent, get hold of Sean and come and do the things.
Yeah. Let's support the local markets, guys. Come try out the food.
So, overall experience?
I'm going to go for a 9 out of 10 on the overall experience.
I'm also going to go for a 9 out of 10. I loved it was COVID friendly. The market is really at a great location. The only thing is, obviously, we had to wait quite a while for our food, which is
normal for fresh food.
It's normal for fresh food. It's worth the wait. But I mean, I was super hungry.
Yeah.
So I would have liked my food sooner than what we got it.
But no issues. The food were all warm, fresh.
Sufficient parking.
Yeah. Enough tables just for seating away from people if you want to be. Well done, Sean. You did a great job.
So thank you for watching.
Cheers, guys.